Hey, what is up, Nation? In this video, I'm going to show you how to make transparent PNG files in Sketchup. I downloaded this file off the 3D warehouse. It was made by Next Designs 2009. So thank you for this awesome model. And what you might want to do something use something like this for is to export your 3D image so that you can maybe like photo montage it on top of something else in Photoshop or for any other number of reasons. And typically when you go to export, you go to 2D graphic, and if I was to just export this, I'm just going to name it to, let's say, living room. And I just hit export. I'll just show you what you see. If I go another step and bring that into Photoshop, you can see that the sky is not transparent, but the background is, or the ground plane is. So what I want is the whole thing to be transparent. And what you have to do here is sort of like select the sky and delete it. And you can do that, but why make extra work for yourself when you can just do it straight from SketchUp? So the way to do that is you can see you want to make sure one thing first. In your 2D graphic, there's a little button down here that says options. You want to make sure that you have transparent background selected. And then in your style, if you don't have this tray open, you can open that by going to default tray, and then you want to hit show tray. That would be show. Right now it's showing, so it says hide. When you go to your styles, go to edit. And right now you can see the ground plane is off. That's why it showed up as transparent when it exported. If I turn the sky off here and I go to File, Export 2D Graphic, PNG, I'm going to change this to Living Room 2. Now we're back in Photoshop. This is what we had before. What I'm going to do is I'm going to drag over the other file that I have. I'm going to hide this one, and you can see that this whole thing is transparent. So if I have like if I want to change the background to red, I can do that. And I don't have to worry about using the magic wand or the marquee tool to go around things and select them and delete things. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please subscribe, like this video, and share this with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.